Guard, red lights on. Set, they're about to burn. The baby stand. Off and racing. Mine Host Welt, so did Weaponize at the start. The first to get going, Just So Sassy. Left the gates very quickly, and so did Universal Playboy, rushing through, getting up outside of Just So Sassy early by sector. In behind those, travelling up there, fourth is Jean Yeller from Hot Chatter, then Mine Host beginning to pick up some ground over on the inside of Dezayne Grey. Megami posted very wide back there in the field with Goalkeeper, then Weaponize, and last of all is Madame Le Pen as they approach the 450. Just So Sassy will straighten up narrowly in front. On the outside is Bisector. Two lengths, Jean Yeller. Over on the inside is Universal Playboy. A gap then to Mine Host. They put the 250 behind them. Bisector races to the lead by a length and a half to Jean Yeller. Universal Playboy struggling to pick them up. Bisector with 100 left to go. Jean Yeller trying hard. Bisector, Jean Yeller. Jean Yeller got on equal terms and Jean Yeller won it. Jean Yeller, the Durant stable, have tipped off the Miller camp again in the first two. Jean Yeller beat home Bisector. Goalkeeper came late down the outside. Might have grabbed third in front of Universal Playboy. In behind those then was Weaponized from well back, made up good ground. Then Mine Host, followed by Madame Le Pen, Just So Sassy. It weakened out of contention. Hot Chatter, Megami are back there, and Dezayne Grey amongst the last of them home. So a very good start for the day for the Durant Yard and Clint Johnston Porter. So they've got the playbook here today, the Durant stable. And the playbook says that they've got to beat the Miller stable. And that they've done in the first two. Mia Gusto rolling El Patron. Jean Yeller getting over the top of Bisector. And down the outside, Goalkeeper runs to third, just in front of Universal Playboy Mine Host. Jean Yeller, a half to three $100,000 stake earners, including Indigo Blue, Mr. Genoa, good winning family. A Universal Ruler filly owned by Adam and Vicky Durant, trained by Adam Durant, a winning double for Clint Johnston Porter. Bisector by Demerit from Perpendicular, trained by Simon Miller for Nick Petrides, A. Hart, M. Young, R.W. Farris, T. Gardner, A. Sirikowski, T. Houlihan, T. Weir, and R. Duropoulos. Handled there by Holly Watson, and third number one Goalkeeper by Snippet Son from Bella's Keeper for RL, G. Hummerston, R. Burton, trained by David Harrison and ridden by Jason Whiting. 2.11.1 for Universal Playboy, the favourite, weighed in fourth spot. But it's Jean Yeller who steps out like a stablemate for the first time and has produced a winning performance. Johnston Porter there, with the Persuader in the left, just guiding her away. Just off Bisector, who gave plenty there. Had to do the breeze work, a bit like its stablemate in the first. It's almost been a carbon copy, the first two races on the card. Now, the third event of the day, the free entry to Belmont Park Handicap. It's over the 1,000 once again. And in the next event, there are no changes. Now, those other details are half by three quarters. 59.44, 34.89, the concluding 600 metres. So almost a carbon copy in every sense of the word after the first two races on the program. Britt?
That's right. Adam Durant having the first two winners of the day, and Jason Miller now does join me. Jace, you said after the previous event that you'd be really confident with Jean Yeller. The only thing that concerned you that there was one in there that you were worried might have too much ability, but not the case. She rose to the fore.
Did a good job. No surprise. And he rode her well. And she's out of a good family that we've had a lot to do with. So it's good to see her winning a race.
You obviously do know the family oh so well. Is she typical of the family? You mentioned when we spoke to you previously that she's one that works on her own. So I'm taking it she's a pretty automatic.
Yeah, they've got a lot of similar traits. She's probably a little bit better behaved than Indigo Blue used to be, but they all can run. They've all got ability, and hopefully she's got a bright future.
It's a perfect way to start the day. In the next, Extra Secrets has her first start for your stable for Bob Peters. How's that horse settled into the routine?
No, she's going well. the 1,000 might be a tad short. She'll be hitting the line, but she's going super at home. Looks a treat. So, yeah, she'll run well.
Good luck on trying to make this an opening treble, but well done on the double.
Thank you.
There is Jason Miller, and over to Clint Johnson-Porter, who's also had an opening double.
Yes, well, we're talking about Extra Secret in the next race, Clint, already, because we talked in race number one. There was a good rap for the winner of Mia Gusto, and then you gave Gianella a good rap. Can you give a good rap to Extra Secret in the next over the 1,000 first up?
Yeah, I hope so. Look, her trials have been good, so I just hope she can bring it to the races. She looked a bit difficult last prep, and I think we've got that under control this prep.
And today, Gianella on debut. She did everything really well. Very impressive.
Yeah, she's actually a little professional, this horse. Probably be the most quietest two-year-old I'll ride in a while. Just does everything very professional. And look, she felt like a winner a long way out.
Speaking of two-year-olds, seems like Adam's got a lot at the trials every time you look. So hopefully it's a nice few months ahead. Congratulations. Well done.
Yeah, thank you.
There is Clint Johnson-Porter. Gianella wins on debut, the daughter of Universal Ruler out of Jean. She takes out the Crown Perth Maiden.